Thanks for joining the Astro Room, your very own portal to the cosmos. Let's explore. Have you ever seen these beautiful images of stars with spikes and wonder, how can I do it with the Seestar? Is it even possible? Yep, it is, and it's super easy. I'll show you how with the imaging of several different stars with the Seestar. Let's get to it. Now before I show you, let's take a look at some of the images of stars I've taken with the Seestar. Most people take images of nebula and galaxy, deep space stuff, which is all good too. But have you tried imaging some of the brightest stars? They come out really nice. So this is Betelgeuse, taken with the Seestar. The image on the left is a raw image. Now, what I mean by raw image is that it's directly from the Seestar, like no editing whatsoever. This is a 3-minute image. And the image on the right, it's post-processed. I used a mobile app called Lightroom to process the raw image to bring out the star's natural orange-reddish colors. And that's what you're seeing there. Now, keep in mind I live in very light polluted skies, basically a Bortle 8. But I mean, these images are pretty cool. All right, now let's see how some of these same pictures look, this time with diffraction spikes. Okay, so here it is. And on the left image, you are seeing it straight from the Seestar in stargazing mode before it even starts stacking pictures. In other words, I haven't even hit the red recording button yet. It's just in preview mode. It's a truly raw image, but this time it just has the diffraction spikes. Now, I know what you mean, or what you're wondering. How did I do it? I will explain, bear with me. It's actually really easy. But first, on the right-hand side, you see the raw image again, but this time 1 minute stacked, as in I've already hit the record button. But now it has a diffraction spikes. It looks pretty cool, right? And nothing fancy added to this, no editing. Remember, I said these are raw images. The only difference now is that they have spikes to give it that classic star pointed look. Okay, here it is again, but this time it's post-processed in the Lightroom mobile app, and I kept the spikes. The only difference with the one on the right-hand side is that it's just zoomed in a bit more. Okay, let's take a look at Rigel, the blue supergiant star. See how it turns out with the diffraction spikes. First here, they are both imaged at 4 minutes stacked. The one on the left is raw and the one on the right is post-processed in the Lightroom mobile app to try and bring out its natural color a bit. Okay, so now here's Rigel again, or Rigel, at 5 minutes, the raw image. As I mentioned earlier, what I mean by raw is that it's not processed, just it's straight from the Seestar. But this time here, it is with the diffraction spikes. I think I was just playing around with the exposure settings here on the Seestar app for a bit, and that's why one of the pictures looks a little brighter and bigger than the other one. Okay, so here it is again, going from left to right at 6 minutes stacked, then 11 minutes stacked, and then 12 minutes. They look pretty amazing already, and they're not even post-processed. Okay, here it is, the final image at 13 minutes stacked. On the left is the raw, and the right side is the post-processed image, both with diffraction spikes. Now, just for comparison between two stars, I have Sirius here, the binary star. Raw image is on the left at 5 minutes, and on the right, 5 minutes post-processed, both with diffraction spikes. Okay, now here's a side-by-side comparison of all three stars with the spikes, and post-processed, of course. Okay, so to make the diffraction spikes on the stars, you simply place any one of these spike covers on the Seestar telescope lens area. So you want to be really careful with this so you don't scratch the lens. Now these are 3D printed and you can purchase them anywhere on eBay or on Etsy. There are several sellers that make these specifically for the Seestar. They come perfectly sized for the lens viewer. You place one of them on the lens and they fit just right and they do not touch the glass. You can put them on before you start imaging or even later on whenever you want to stack an image. It's really up to you. When I was doing it, I was just taking it on and off every few minutes, even while it was live stacking. It wasn't even messing up the image at all. And that's it.